I'm discussing about this experiment again. We have discussed about the measurement of the vertical angles with the help of theodolite here. And theodolite is basically a device which helps in the surveying work. The apparatus required for this particular arrangement will be tripod stands, theodolite that is modern or the normal one, and the at least three ranging rods for doing this survey work, right? So the theory part remains the same about the theodolite, its functioning, its application, and the process we were discussing, that in order to find out the vertical angle that is of two types, either at a particular elevation to a particular height we are looking, or it is the angle of depression in terms of vertical angle. So if we are looking to a valley shaped area, we are surveying in particular hilly region in the downward direction, then we require the vertical angle. So it is done with respect to the axis of the instrument. We suppose that the base of the instrument, the axis is the base of the instrument, and with respect to that we find out these two type of angle which you are able to see in the, which are able to see in that particular screen, like the angle of elevation if we are looking towards the top of the hillside, or if we are suppose standing at a particular position on the top of particular side and we are looking towards the valley shaped area in the downward direction. These are the two vertical angles. One will be the angle of elevation and the other will be the angle of depression. So the process which has been shown, or the steps which we need to take for finding these angles, has been illustrated in front of you. First, we will set up our theodolite at a particular station that we say it as O. Right? This is the position where we are placing our instrument. We are doing the complete temporary adjustments. In temporary adjustments, we have the arrangements of making the vernier scale or the readings on the vernier scale to be zero. We do it with the help of vertical clamp screws and tangent screws. Both of these type of screws we have discussed and seen during the parts of the theodolite we were discussing, right? So we need to set these vernier scales at zero reading, and then only we start our initial readings to be taken. So that I gave you an example also. If the reading in place of zero is say 1 degree, 20 minute and 30 second, or it is 2 degree, then the entire readings which you are going to take, and all the readings will show you a deflection of that particular value of 2 degree or 1 degree, 20 minute and 30 seconds on. Right? So we need to identify that error in the starting of the survey. Try to remove it first and then proceed with the readings. Then next point says that we are already taking the readings on both the vernier scale, and the mean, that is the average of these readings, will be required. So we do not consider any one value as the final one. We try to take out the average of the two values. And that will be required vertical angle. Similarly, if we were taking reading on the left side, we will be taking reading on the right side. Against the right side of the angle. So the average of the two values will again be and in this way we can take the readings on both the sides, that is towards the left and towards the right. Similarly, the angle of depression is shown to you in the figure that I have already explained. Now, moving forward, we have this type of table, tabular data, which we need to fill out. So we have the instrument station. Suppose here it was named as 0.0. So other different type of reading also we will be taking. We were looking at two different points from the O position. First, we are looking towards, say, M, and another time we were looking towards M dash. We have vernier readings. We will be taking actually two vernier readings. One we will note down in the column C, another we will note down in the column T. That will be face left readings. And the mean of these value will give us the mean angle. And we will name it as either angle of elevation or the angle of depression, whatever may be the case. Now, in order to measure this angle between two points, say L and M, here are two points. This is L, this is M. We are taking two readings. So first of all, we will set up our instrument at point O. Two conditions or two cases may arise. Either this L point is at angle of elevation and M is at angle of depression, or both are at an angle of elevation. This may be the case. So let us understand. We'll set up our vernier scale. We'll set up the vernier scale both C and D to zero again by the help of this clamp screws as well as the tangent screws. Then the altitude level should remain at the center. Means this particular position should always be at the center, which we are saying this. This is imaginary line. This is the axis of the instrument. Now the face of the theodolite should be left. First, we are taking it for left direction towards the left of the instrument. Then we will be bisecting the object at point L and taking the readings. Okay, so what we will do, by the help of this baseline, we will be taking this angle L, whatever may be the value. Similarly for M also, whether it is at depression or both are at elevation, we will be taking the readings, and both the readings of vernier will be noted down. For both the cases, we will find out the mean angles, that is the average value of the angle. The sum or the difference of these angles will give us the values of L and M. So if this is the case where both the readings are on the opposite side of this baseline, then we will be adding up the angles. So whatever will be the value of this particular angle, that is L, O, and say this is X. So LOX plus XOM, these two angles combination will give us the value of this particular angle O. And that will be the reading in the first case. Similarly, for the second case, whatever angle has been prepared by this line LOX will be subtracted by this angle MOX. So the difference of these two readings will give us the value of this particular angle, which is formed between line L and M. And that angle will be known as LOM. These are the two cases which we have discussed right now. Then, moving further, the observation table will be prepared in this manner. We will be having the instrument station, say, who is the station. We are sighting towards two different points, two different angles we are taking at L and at M. Then we will be having two readings for left and two readings for right. We are preparing the same table for face right reading also. We'll take up the average of these angles, and that will be the value of the vertical angle. In case we have any remarks, we can note down the values as well. So the average value of the vertical angle is find out to be, so whatever the values you are finding out, the average of those values will be the vertical angle reading. The precautions which you need to take care while performing this experiment in particular case, I am highlighting that. First of all, you should introspect in the beginning itself whether the parts of the theodolite are loose or not, whether the screws are tightened or not. Second thing, without removing the dust from the objective lens or the eyepiece, you should not continue with the experiment. I told you before also, for this accurate reading and observation sites should be clear. So the lens brush are available, the lens tissues are also available along with the devices. So it is a very delicate device. The lens are to be taken utmost care, and therefore you need to clean those with the help of the lens brushes or the lens tissues. Then we have to keep the lens covered until and unless theodolite is not in use. This is the biggest issue created by people in the field, that without taking the reading also they keep the theodolite open. That is in terms of lens we are talking, it is open. Because the lens are very much sensitive, the refractive index values keeps on changing due to the direct sunlight or the heat or the temperature differences created. So whenever we are taking the reading, that time we can obviously remove the lid over the lenses, and once done with the reading, we should close it again. So the last precaution which you should adopt or you can adopt is, we should provide a sunshade over the protective for the protection purposes of the lens, because this can be done with the help of say for example an umbrella, or you can provide some temporary shades over that places where from you are taking the readings. That will help you a lot in terms of accuracy level. So this was the experiment, or the practical we can say, how to measure the vertical angles with the help of the छोटो लाइट।